I take you back 40 years ago when the world's first IVF baby, Louis Brown, was born. Believe me, at that time, it was a revolution, a scientific revolution, because science had then proved that human gametes could be fertilized in the laboratory, create an embryo, and transfer it into a woman to have a normal child. There was euphoria, and I remember as a small child then that all the newspapers had flashed it on their front pages. But with every discovery, at first, the discovery is widely ridiculed and violently opposed. And this is what happened for IVF. The doctors were ostracized, peers, religious groups opposed it violently. It's after a few years, with overwhelming evidence, the discovery was reluctantly and partially accepted by the peers. It took almost 2 decades for humanity in general to realize that they have benefited largely from it, and they hailed it as though there was never any opposition. And the inventors of IVF, a good 35 years later, were awarded the Nobel Prize. Ladies and gentlemen, for today's talk on innovation for the masses, I bring to you my concept of a generation on ice, preserving your fertility, cryopreservation of sperms, eggs, embryos, and ovaries. You may all know that this was intended for the young adults who, in their prime of career, were afflicted with cancers. Cancers such as leukemias, lymphomas, cancer of the breast, testicular cancers. Now, if these cancers fortunately are detected early, most of these young adults are cured and would then go on to lead a normal full lifespan. But the unfortunate part was that when they decided to have their own family, they were rendered sterile by the chemotherapy and the radiotherapy that they used to fight this very cancer. That this is very devastating to them because quite often they would have to resort to donor gametes. The social reason nowadays, in addition to this, is that most of us are aware that our lifespan has increased. But very few people know that even though we would live to the ripe age of 80, my fertility is only for 20 years, from age 20 to age 40. And quite often when people defer their reproduction, thinking that they are going to live long so they could try having a family later, they're disappointed and quite often reclused. Now, freezing of sperms is not new. It's been done almost 300 years back, particularly the horse stallion sperms, which were freezed and then transported to have the pedigree horses. But it took scientists almost 300 years to master that act in humans. And that was because the human cells contain a large amount of water, and at room temperature, the water molecules are randomly arranged. And in the traditional freezing, as the cell freezes, the water molecules become rigid. And if you remember your science classes, the water, when it becomes ice, will swell, and the ice will rupture the cell walls, thereby destroying the very tissue that you intend to preserve. Now, for human gametes to be useful after freezing, we need to freeze them to minus 196 degrees Celsius. And at that temperature, traditional freezing would destroy the cells beyond recovery. So how is science changing, and how it is changing the fertility scenario? We realized that water is the culprit. So the water was removed, the cells were dehydrated, and replaced with something called as cryoprotectant. This is something which can withstand the freezing even at minus 196 degrees. The cells do not swell up. And along with that, another eye-opener was a technique of vitrification, which is instantaneous freezing, which means the temperatures from 37 degrees are brought down to minus 196 degrees in mere seconds, not allowing the ice crystals to form, not allowing the cells to expand, giving a glassy-like appearance, thereby preserving the integrity of these cells. So these two very basic techniques, dehydrating the cell and instant freezing, helped us to preserve gametes. Now you may ask me, why would we need to freeze sperms? Yes, in young men who are afflicted with cancer prior to their treatment. But we also like to freeze sperms in men who have had critical illnesses where their sperm counts can rapidly reduce. We need to store sperms for the donor sperm program to ensure that the donor is healthy after 6 months and doesn't transmit any infections. And in this busy age, we need to freeze the husband's sperm in case they are unable to be present when the wife is undergoing the infertility treatment. Now, who should freeze eggs? Yes, young women who are afflicted with cancers. But the social reason nowadays is that women who would wish to defer their fertility for career and educational goals. Women diagnosed with severe endometriosis or recurrent cyst, which is destroying the ovaries, and women who would technically want to halt their biological clock. So they would like to conserve and preserve their young eggs and use them maybe a decade later so that their fertility is restored back to them. We can even freeze bits and pieces of the ovary. The ovaries retrieved through keyhole surgeries, and these bits are further sliced so that they can be freezed, and these sliced portions can be transferred back into the woman so that she can regain her fertility. And nowadays, women prefer to use this as a form of hormone replacement therapy in the menopausal age. We can even freeze fertilized eggs, which are called as embryos, because when you harvest eggs in IVF, you get more than what you need. So you could replace them back one at a time so that the woman can come back to have a second child without undergoing the whole treatment of IVF. We can freeze embryos to test these embryos to ensure that they do not carry any genetic problems which are there in their parents so that it is not passed down to future generations. And we can freeze embryos of couples who have been diagnosed with malignancy and need to preserve their fertility. So ladies and gentlemen, if I want to retain my father's laugh with my mother's sense of humor, if I want to retain my mother's temperament and my father's temper, and if I want to have my father's mouth with my mother's taste, I need to retain my fertility. I should have the choice to conserve and preserve my fertility and use it whenever I deem fit. Thank you very much.